Hello friends, welcome. I just wanted to make a video about how we can perceive spirit and sense spirit and the ways they come around when they're near to us and what we might begin to pick up. So, many people do feel their sense in spirit at times, and very mildly, now spirit are beings of energy, light and energy, and so the way we might first begin to perceive them is their energies. So most often, of course, when we go into a more spiritual mode whereby we could sense spirit, it's quite often when you're doing something like the washing up. You know, it's quiet, you're doing a job where your conscious mind turns off and your subconscious begins to daydream. And that is what the spirit realm works through. Those spirit, they work through our subconscious and communicate to us through our subconscious. So at times like that, when you're vaguely staring out the window and not seeing anything, when you're doing the washing up and you're not focusing on anything, your subconscious just daydreaming, that's a perfect time to start sensing spirit.
Excuse me.
And the way we usually quite often sense them in that situation is you might feel a slight hand on your shoulder or a touch on your shoulder. And you're thinking, did I feel that? Didn't I feel that? But that's the way they do work. And the other way is energies. So you become aware of their energies. And it's like the hairs on the back of your neck start standing on end. And, you know, that's just their energies doing that. It's nothing to be frightened of. It's just purely them blending around your aura, because they're here also. Spirit that pass into the spirit realm, God has given them an ability to stay here as well at the same time. So they can be in two places. They can be in the spirit realm and here, and they can come and visit us, and they're little spirit orbs, and they can see and hear and communicate with us clairvoyantly and spiritually, and they fly around. They can actually fly through doors, so they can come in and visit us and be with their loved ones. And our spirit guides are also spirit orbs down here. Spirit can also communicate to us from the spirit realm, but when we're sensing energies, it's normally because they are actually here in spirit orb form, blending in our aura, and we can start to pick up on those energies. So the other time that is a great opportunity to start sensing spirit is we go and get ready for bed, and we get into bed, and we lay down and we start to go to sleep. And at that point, spirit will sometimes, our loved ones mostly, but guides occasionally, will come into our bedroom when we're going to sleep. And they will blend in our aura. And as the mind goes through the transition, because when we're asleep, we're far more perceptive, because of course the conscious mind's gone to sleep, and the spiritual mind's more active, and the subconscious is more active while we sleep. So that's a perfect time for them to come as we're going to sleep, because the mind goes in that phase of halfway in between sleep and being awake. So the conscious mind has shut down, the subconscious is free, and we can start to perceive spirit at times like that. We might begin to have a sort of daydreamy like state of visualizing something about spirit, or see a colour, or have a thought just percolate through our subconscious mind into our awareness. So that's the way spirit works through the subconscious. It's like they use your mind, because they can't think audibly into your mind other than doing it through your mind, and mostly it's just feelings or sensing something they mean rather than of audible voice, although clairaudience is possible. So it sort of percolates and surfaces into our consciousness, and we sort of become a bit more aware. And it's the mode. The mind goes from one phase of mode into another mode as we go to sleep. So it's that in-between transition that we can perceive them. If you are aware there might be spirit around you trying to communicate to you, and at times your senses may increase more so than that. It's like you might be sitting in a chair with your eyes closed, for instance, just daydreaming or thinking about things in a relaxed state, and you will find that you can start to feel little tiny kisses on your cheeks, or the hairs on the back of your neck start standing up because their energies are energizing you. And you can imagine that if you put energy or heat or something like that onto somebody, it will make the hairs on their body stand on end. So that's all it is. And then you might feel like tingling sensations around your neck and shoulders and face, and you know, even your ears and stuff. You can feel little energy tingles all around you. Or sometimes when you start really becoming a bit more than that, you can start to feel like a cobweb feeling. It feels like little cobwebs all over your face, but that's just, again, the spirit energies. And those that start really developing or meditating can find that they get all those senses, but they get like itching on their face as well, and it becomes quite intense because spirit have to share all the power they've got to try and wake us up spiritually inside to perceive them, our chakra energy system that we have as spiritual beings ourselves. They have to power it up and, you know, to become more perceptive to us. And also you can find that when you start to develop, you can feel pressures inside your mind, inside your body sometimes, and it's spirit powering your chakra up, because we perceive spirit greatly through our own spirit, of course, and through our chakra system, which is the energy centers within our spirit and aura and such like. So you can feel expansions and pressures. And the other thing that those that do meditate get is spirit use a lot of energy to open us up, and it feels like there's a pressure on top of your head or on top of your brain, and it feels like it's heavy pushing down on you, but that is just pure spirit energy trying to open your mind up. But it's after about 15 minutes or so, it can actually give you a headache, but it's not detrimental to you. But, you know, it can become, you know, quite a bad headache after quite a while, because they're using so much power to develop you in the beginning. Later on, it decreases what they have to use, because your own chakra, the more you do it, keep developing and become more powerful and open up more so they don't have to use so much energy. But, you know, be aware it can give you a headache. And, you know, it's like any headache, it takes time to go afterwards. But, you know, you have to try and bear it if you want to. Now, in spiritual meditation, if you go forward to do spiritual meditation, you absolutely must learn how to do it properly, because it's good to learn how to open all your chakra up to become perceptive of spirit, but you must always put this bubble of light all around yourself to protect any negative emanations or spirit coming to you, which it doesn't 100% guarantee they won't, but if you only want beings of light and you put light around yourself, you keep negativity at bay more so. But you must learn to close the chakra down. Absolutely. Because if you start developing your chakra, become open. If you leave them open, you walk around in an open state in your chakras, and you start picking up all these negative feelings from people around you or any negative spirit that wants to come to you. So you walk around in the supermarket and you're getting all these strange emotions and feelings and don't know what's happening to you. It's because you're still open, so you must always learn to close the chakra down. So that's important, very important. You know, highly developed mediums, to open the chakra, go through a sequence of opening each one and closing each one afterwards. But highly developed mediums, they can just go like a light switch and turn them on. And after they finish, like a light switch, turning them off, because they just think, I want to communicate with spirit, automatically happens. They light up in spirit, and when they're finished, they are just knowing. They don't want to know, hear spirit anymore, and it just automatically closes them. Now, the chakra never fully close, because there are life force providers, so if they completely close, we'd be dead. So, you know, they only close down to their normal level, and the chakra are spinning discs of energy, or you can visualize them as a ball of energy, expanding or contracting back to a normal state. But, you know, they are the energy providers of our life, and greatly we perceive through them. The crown chakra is the higher self. The brow chakra is your inner eye and mind. You've got a throat chakra, and spirit can talk through you sometimes if they want to. You can take on their accent, their voice, everything. So you've got the heart chakra, emotions. You've got the solar plexus chakra between your rib cage and navel, which is the intuitive gut feeling chakra. So you intuitively know things about somebody around you. It's because you're perceiving it there. And then you've got the spleen chakra, the sacral chakra, which is about sexuality and stuff like that. And the base root chakra at the bottom of your spine and your pelvis, which grounds you and makes you aware of more earthly things. So yeah, that's good to do those things. So that's some of the ways you can perceive spirit. When you're meditating, they can communicate to you in several ways. They can give you feelings or senses or images in your mind. Their thoughts can percolate as knowledge or awareness through your subconscious mind. Or, at best, you can start hearing their voice audibly. And not always in your mind. Quite often in your mind you hear a voice, but that's quite advanced. But some can do it quite easily. But also, you might hear their voice coming out of the air at you, as though you can hear it through your ears. So it's all spiritual, it's none of it's physical. But spirit can also begin then to overshadow you in meditation, that they put themselves upon you and they blend with you and become part of you, and they can talk through you, and they can walk through you, because they can take control through that, in being able to talk openly through you to others, or just through you when they want to, and actually control your body. And you know, people that are possessed, that happens to them, they get overshadowed. But also there's trance mediumship, where a spirit takes partial or full control of the person, and that person, when it's partial control, is still aware of what that spirit's doing through them. But in deep trance, that many mediums do, their mind is pushed to an unconscious state to one side, their conscious mind, and the spirit can take full control. A trusted spirit guide, that is, that they trust, takes full control, maybe to deliver a philosophy or a teaching or something like that, or do a healing. Some do trance healings as well, that the guide has full possession. It's their mind in your mind doing what they want to do through you. They have control of your body and of your mind completely. And then when they relinquish that control, they move back and the medium or healer comes back into their mind, and they don't know what's happened in that meantime. So that's why possession actually works. There are negative spirit. They do overshadow us at times. That's why it's important to protect, or at worst possess us, and they can take control of your conscious mind forcibly. And you know, that's through people that are weak, you know, or fearful. And you know, it's not their fault for being that, of course not, but you know, it's very important, if you want to do spiritual meditations and work with spirit, not to fear. Because if you start fearing, that's a negative thing, and you draw negativity to you. And the more you fear, if you do get a negative spirit with you, the more control they will have over you, because you're doing exactly what they want you to do, fear them, and therefore they can virtually frighten you out of your mind. Whereas if you are very positive, you can expound them out of your mind, you can push them away with the light within yourself, with the bubble of light around yourself, you can cast them away and you know, push them out of you, and you become far less aware of them. So, you know, I have got meditation for spiritual protection, and also about possession, just to warn people of the dangers there are. You know, like anything in life, some dangers about being spiritually aware, because there are. There's no hell, there are no demons, but the spirit realm is open to all to cross over into, good or bad, and they don't necessarily change in the spirit realm. And, you know, our loved ones and our guides will do their absolute utmost to protect us from such things. But really, at the present time, they don't have ultimate power to take a negative spirit away from the spirit realms, or spirit orb down here, away from us. So it is important, you know, that we get justice from the spirit realm to protect us more so, you know, but it takes unity in the spirit realm to do so, and they don't always get along, unfortunately, but hopefully it will come soon, you know, and I'm doing my best to get that too, and I hope everybody will say a little prayer to the spirit realm asking them to work together to bring us justice, and you know, because if they did, they could achieve it, and they could police us much better than they are at the present time. So that would be good for us all. So, you know, and the majority of spirit are just like us here. They're good people, and some are more evolved. But the majority are on the next plane still, but they're good people. So that's some of the ways you can become aware of spirit. There are many other things. Now, if you start getting interested in healing, and you know, you're sitting there meditating to find your spirit guides, and you keep getting this pain, say in your shoulder, oh, every time I meditate, I get this pain in my shoulder, and I don't know what it means. Well, what it means is there's somebody out there that's got that condition that spirit are trying to encourage you to ask for. They're not telling you why they're giving you that pain, but they're giving you it so you realise that you need to ask and say a prayer, or ask spirit to give that person that's got that condition healing. and you send your love and healing to that person. You might not know who they are, or you might know who they are, but you send your love and healing to them, and you say to your spirit, please take it away now, I don't want it any longer, and it won't come again. But another pain might come at another time, and you'll know what to do that time, won't you? So, I bless you, I hope this has been informative. Love and light to you, Shep.